Buenos Dias Gunners Collective, back at it like a smack addict. And as you can tell by today's thumbnail, yes, indeedy, I wrote graffiti all over that motherfucking bus. And indubitably, I'm bringing you guys some heat. I'm bringing you guys an exclusive interview with one Mr. Dre. And for those of you that don't know who he is, first and foremost, I will say that he represents that Northern Rider movement. But at the same time, well, I will also say that he is the man behind the incident with one Scrappy, the self-proclaimed butcher, right? So without further ado, let me introduce this man, one Mr. Dre from the Rider Movement. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Hey, what's up, my boy? This is Dre out of West Sac. I'm a certified rider, especially Mitchell, bro. I'm just here to talk about this clown, you know? And all these issues that's been going on, all this paperwork and stuff that he's been posting on YouTube, you know? And I was there in Corcoran 3B when he arrived there in the beginning of May. And he came talking all this massa, and he had some kites from the homie Snoop that it was okay for him to program with us and all this stuff, right? So we told him, it's okay, we're going to take a look into this stuff, and then we'll go on from there. So the minute he got off orientation, though, we started watching this dude running around the yard and stuff. We heard that dude was asking for a knife from some dude and stuff. So I took it upon myself to just go ahead and say, you know what, I'm gonna get rid of this dude before he tries to hurt one of the bus, you know? So next thing you know, they're doing every hour unlock to go to the yard, and I heard that he was out there. So, you know, I get my knife ready, I put my shoes on, everything. I go out there, and I see him working out. He's over there by the pull-up bars. The minute I see him, I start going to work, man. I blasted him about 4 to 5 times. And my buddy was right there at the time. His name is Criminal. He got in it, but he just started fighting old boy, you know? So it's not doing much. So I get back in it. I get back in it instead of getting rid of the weapon. And I start going to work again on this dude, you know? I blasted my friend, which was a Criminal, a few times because he didn't know what to do. He was youngster, you know? He was hugging Scrappy instead of hurting him. He was in the way. So meanwhile, I'm blasting Scrappy, I blast the Criminal, and then my friend from across the yard, big shout out to Matt Ball, and comes into work once everything was said and done, though, and we start stomping him out. He's on the ground and stuff, you know. After that, we all get down and stuff and start throwing bombs at us, you know, and pepper spray us, whatever we're not. We all lay down in the yard, and as you can see, I sent you the pictures, but they're too graphic. They got blood all over and stuff like that. It's me laying down on the floor on the yard. I got the knife right next to me. You can see Scrappy right there bleeding and stuff. When they picked us up, though, they noticed that Scrappy was stabbed a few times, more than a few times. So they take him to the hospital right away. And then they see my friend that he got hit a few times, too, because he was in the way. And they take him to the hospital, too. When I get up, though, they look at us. I got a few scratches and stuff, you know. I got a few scratches here and there from doing my thing. A few of the homies got a few scratches, too. So they go and give these dudes medical treatment. So on the write-up, they're going to do whatever they want to make you look like you're the bad guy, like every single one of us, because they wanted to put everybody in the hole. So they gave everybody a stabbing, and they gave Scrappy a stabbing. That's how he came up with that paperwork that he has. But I got my paperwork, you know. Everybody got their paperwork. But more important than anything, I got the pictures, and the pictures show everything, you know. I'm not bleeding or nothing. The dude is leaking like a motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? He got butchered. The butcher got butchered. So that was it, man. We go to the hall, IGI comes and gets this dude. We end up going to court behind this stuff, you know what I'm saying? He made a few interviews and everything before everybody went to court, and they're using it against us. But I ended up taking 23 years, so everything's done and set with, you know what I'm saying? This shit don't even matter no more. We can speak on it now. But that dude made a statement and shit, you know? And they were using it against us by court, saying that we try to kill him and some more stuff, you know what I'm saying? This dude's just an imposter, man. He was never a writer, you know?
Absolutely, bro. So I don't mean to cut you off, but at the same time, so what was the reasoning? If I could backtrack a little bit, what was the reasoning initially behind this guy Scrappy being under any type of freeze or suspicion hitting that yarda? Meaning, what made you guys become aware, homie, that something was wrong with this guy. You know what I mean?
Well, he had already did a few grimy stuff, man. Like, he landed in Kern Valley, CR. This is back in 2014 when we put a stop to Northern Riders, and we just started pushing certified riders. And that dude was ready. The dude had already stepped back. He had already stepped back in another prison and tried to get re-embraced at that prison, Kern Valley 180 CR. And the homies voted for him to come in. And then Snoop and some other homies said, hey, that's a beetle boat. That's no good. You know what I'm saying? So old boy got scared. And what he did is he stabbed some innocent bystanders to get up out of that yard. So he ended up in Salinas Valley, where he started recruiting and pumping fear into people into becoming NCs and stuff, you know? So that's what made us go against him. You know, he started his own little movement and manipulated our people into something else.
Yeah, I've heard several interviews with them, and I'm not going to slander those interviews because the interviewee or the interviewer is actually a friend of mine. But I was going to say, at the same time, I've heard that he's talked on many occasions that he was one of the founding members of the writer movement. Right now, I myself do know Snoop. Just talked to him not even an hour ago, right? Personally. And I also want to put out there for the viewers that at no point in time does Gunners Collective endorse or embrace the ideology of the Northern Riders. To each their own. You know what I mean? We're not with them or against them. We're just here being unbiased and for the raza. But at the same time, I will say that I have tapped in with Snoop, and I consider him a friend of mine. And he has told me that at no point in time was this guy ever a founding member. And, you know, I've heard a lot of history, and I've always heard that Snoop is the sole founder of the movement. So was this guy pushing the propaganda saying he was a that he established?
No, what Scrappy did is he came PC off the get-go. When we were pushing riders in the mainline, GP, he was on the SNY. And a lot of people was hearing about this Northern Rider stuff on the GP side, you know? So a lot of dropout Northerners and stuff like that on the SNY, he started pushing Northern Riders to like, they were imposters though. They were under an assumed identity, and Scrappy was like acting like he was one of the main leaders on this side though, on the SNY side, on the PC side. So a lot of people believe that, you know, he manipulated a lot of people into believing that he was one of the main founders when he never was. He never was in mainline. He was never pushing this shit over there in Kern Valley, in the mainline, or Tehachapi, or none of that stuff. You know, like, he was never in the mainline.
Okay, so another question, bro. So I heard, if you could tell the viewers, man, how long were you doing prior to picking up this extra 23 years?
I'm already doing 53 to life, bro.
Okay, so so 23, and you could run another 23. You know what I mean?
No, it's nothing, man. Absolutely. This is what we signed up for.
And I hear you, bro. I hear you. So based on your time and what you're doing and your believement in your cause, that's what made you take up arms and defend your household, basically.
Yeah, straight up, man. The minute I heard dude was asking for some weaponry stock and stuff, I just said, you know what? It's time to go. This dude is either going to make a move on us or we got to make a move on him, you know? And we didn't have no time to figure shit out, whether the guy was good or it was bad. It was just a security issue, you know?
Yeah. So how long did he last on that yarda? How many days was he on that yarda?
Look, he was there on orientation. He was there about 10 days, which he doesn't get to come out of his cell whatsoever. And then he got to come out of his cell like 2 days on the yard, like the actual yard, going out to the yard. He was there 2 days, and then he got blasted, you know?
Yeah. No. I know. Ain't no lie about that. I've been on plenty of yardas, and that's exactly how it goes. You get their orientation till they find bed space, and then it's usually anywhere from 1 week to 2 weeks. So you're absolutely correct. So you from what I heard from a couple of good friends of mine, they've told me that you just recently got back from the county jail. So you're fresh off the boat coming back.
Yeah. No, I've been in prison for 4 years already. 5 years. The homie Snoop in the county jail right now, in LA County. They got him over there under investigation and stuff for some other stuff, you know?
Yeah.
But no, I've been in prison for 4 years, you know?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, I know. I've talked to Snoop, and I'll be interviewing him shortly, pretty soon, and we're going to get down to all that. And I know that what he's fighting, are they trying to tie your case into what he's got going on?
Yeah, and one of them, they charged us all for conspiracy to commit murder on Scrappy Diaz, the same dude, you know? And We already went to court. I already took a deal. I took 23 years for that case. I pled guilty to personally stabbing him and special conditions for gang enhancements and whatnot. You know, Snoop's still fighting it. It's, you got to go get sentenced and stuff. But it's all the same case. They just separated her cases to go to trial because of COVID-19.
Okay. So I heard, yeah, absolutely. So I heard an interview where Scrappy was saying, and I quote, that he was called into the county jail. He was sitting there in LA County Jail as a character witness. Is this, do you know this to be true, or was he there actually on behalf of the district attorney?
I mean, this is a routine the district attorney does every time, you know, regardless whether you're going to testify or not. You have to go to court. You have to be there. And then once you're there, I mean, he's already locked up. He could plead the fifth. He could say he doesn't want to testify or whatever, whatnot, you know, but he has to be there regardless. So that's why they called him down here, you know, but there's nothing he could say. You know, here he had given a statement. Here he had did an interview saying that we tried to kill him. They had already, they used it against us already.
Yeah, and I know that would probably be, would have came in your discovery where you were able to witness that with your own eyes, you know. Did you witness him on paper in your discovery saying exactly what you just said?
No, he didn't. He didn't testify on paperwork against us. But like I said, he made a statement on certain. He made a book. He made a video where he said, keyword, my attorney told me they got these videos, right? He told me, look, they got these videos right now. We're about to go to trial. And this dude is saying we tried to kill him. That's the keyword. So they're not even going to try to get you for assault on the police, on an inmate with a weapon. They're going to go for attempted murder because he's saying on that interview that we tried to kill him, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah, I hear you, man. Hey, and whether or not it's on paperwork, that really doesn't matter. Once it comes out your mouth, it is what it is, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
So as far as that case being done and over with, what is this new cause, I guess, that Scrappy is pushing? Because I've heard him all over the airwaves talking about the NCs. What are the NCs, bro? I have no idea what that is or what's going on with that. I've been out of the loop for a minute, bro. So...
The NCs, like I said, when Scrappy left Kern Valley and we told him that he couldn't be a writer, he couldn't become a writer again, there was no such a thing as stepping back and becoming the writer again, you know? So when he heard that in Kern Valley, what he did is he stepped some two fibers and left to Salinas Valley. Once he was in Salinas Valley, he went over there and manipulated all the writers and the compas that were there into believing that Snoop was pushing the new agenda, that he was going to get everybody stripped. He pumped fear into everybody, you know, and he told them, dudes, we should just do our own thing and start NC, which it was nuestra compa, that's how it originated, you know. But after having talks with Snoop and certain other individuals and told him to keep compas out of his mouth, he started a new thing called Nuestra Cosa. That's how he named his new little clique, you know. But yeah, he's the founder of it. Him and a few other dudes, you know. Absolutely.
Okay, so another question. So with that being said, he's doing his own thing. It is what it is. Basically, he's all bad as far as the writer movement is concerned. Were you actually in the same building with Snoop, or did they keep you guys separated, or how was the makeup of that? Being in LA County Jail, you know, it's just mind-boggling, bro, that you guys are sitting there in LA County Jail. Did they have you guys separated, high power? How were they doing that? Ad seg?
I mean, at one point, we were together right here in DR, LA County, but it's not LA County, it's prison. That's how they call it. They call it LA County Lancaster Prison, you know? And we were right here together in DR, D5 in the hole, right next door to each other. But now they got him in the county, Supermax, where it's LA County, you know?
Oh, okay, I see. Yeah, because I was, you know, a lot of my viewers brought it up to me from down south, and they were like, how are these guys in LA County Jail? And I always assumed you guys just had your own pod or whatever the case may be, you know, for special circumstances.
This is a real high profile case for IGI and ISU. And being that Lancaster is the headquarters for IGI and ISU, these dudes are grimy, man. They're pretty much like another gang, you know what I'm saying? And they'll do whatever they can to fuck with us. So what they did is they grabbed Snoop. They have say so. They grabbed Snoop and put him in LA County, the main county, because supposedly he had too much say so over the riders, and that there was dudes getting stabbed up out here in the yard. They tried to charge him for a conspiracy to attempt a murder on other cats and stuff like that, you know? Because, I mean, they're just doing whatever they can to fuck with us, you know? They don't want us out here in the yards. They just don't want us doing what we do, you know?
No, and I hear you, bro. I hear you with that. Their IGI is always going to minimize contact between you guys and try to put basically a stick in the spokes. That's just how they get down. So they've always been like that. So you find yourself in doing 53 years. Might we ask you, bro, what initially got you caught up and put in prison, you know?
Yeah, I got out, right? And I was doing good. I was already pushing riders. This was in 2014, the beginning of 2014. And there was a few homies that knew me from growing up and stuff that didn't like me because I became a rider and stuff. And these dudes will follow me, you know, they will follow me around and shit. And one day I got tired of this little intimidation tactics they try to do, you know? So I hopped out of my car, man, and dudes bounced out too. There was like two of them cats and I just let them have it. You know, we got into a shootout and stuff. They were active. I blasted old boy about three times. And then they ended up testifying against me. Even though they didn't testify at trial, they testified when he was in the hospital saying that I did that, you know? So a month or 2 months later, they came and arrested me. I didn't think that they were going to have nothing on me because dude was trying to act hella hard at the end, like, oh, I'm not going to snitch, this and that. But they still use, like I said, once you make a statement, whether it's on trial or not, you're going to use that statement, bro, at trial. And they'll convict you off that statement itself, you know? And that's exactly what they did with me in my prior case.
No, right, you know? Off the top. Yeah, right off the top. Once, like I say, once it's out there in the airwaves, it's pretty much done, you know? And so, yeah. so prior to all that, you, at one point in time, you were an active Norteño, I'm sure. And what was the reasoning behind you distancing yourself from that movement, bro? From you know, and I'm not trying to get too involved in the specifics of the politics, but what was the thing that said, you know what, I'm done, I'm no longer going to be an active Norteño and this and that, you know?
Well, you know, I'm from Joe County and stuff, so where I grew up at around West Sacramento, Woodland, all this stuff, it's a real known area for Northern riders. You know, I'm only 28, so growing up, I already had homies that were pushing riders in the streets. And this is real famous out there in West Sacramento, in Sacramento period, Modesto. It's infested, you know what I'm saying? We got our own pots. We don't go with PC. We don't go nowhere. We got our own pots. We got rider spots, and they be 20, 30 deep in that motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? So being that I grew up around these dudes and everything, I had committed a crime when I turned 18. I got into a shootout. It was a drive-by. And when they got me, the drive-by had happened on some active homies, you know? And they were rivals, so when I got locked up, they put me on freeze. They're like, hey, you're on freeze for getting into a shootout with another homies, this and that. I'm only 18, though, remind you, I didn't know really much about politics at that time, you know? And then one of my homies comes to visit me, and the homie happened to be a rider, you know? It was Little Snoop from Salinas. He's dead now. They smoked him out there. And when they see me, they're like, hey, you're already on freeze, and you're bringing riders to come see you over here to the pod, this and that, like, that's just looking bad for you, you know? So I was like, I already took it up on myself because I seen them doing their little meeting out there on the yard, like they were about to do something. So I took it up on myself to get off right there in the county and just go to the rider part, you know? So the minute I seen all this little thing going down at Shaho, when we went out to get our break, to get our dinner, I took off on the homies, you know? That's how I ended up coming to this side.
Basically some red on red. Where you found yourself in a rock and a hard place, you were already on the one-way ticket out anyways. You're talking about Little Snoop, you're talking about Bayo de Salas, right?
Oh, his brother's Pico. He stays out there in Broderick. He was really out there putting in work, too. He was out there on the streets. He was wanted real bad, and they finally got him, man. Rest in peace, you know?
Yeah, you're talking about Bayo, Playboy Snoop, they called him.
Yeah, absolutely.
I happened to have a prima that knew him. Anyway, so to Trip. Man, with all that being said, man, it's a cold game that you find yourself at 28 years old doing a combined, 76 years to life, man. You know, for just basically putting in work and it's just, you know, I push a positive message on this channel, bro. And I'm all about uniting the raza. At the same time, man, every story is unique. Every story is different, man. And I appreciate that you gave me your time to get on here and clear the air basically on what Scrappy Diaz is saying. And basically, absolutely, man, to speak your piece, homie, and to put out there what you know to be true and what is your truth, you know?
Go ahead. I was going to ask if we could put these pictures up of Scrappy, you know, but they're a little bit too graphic and stuff. So I understand that we cannot put them on YouTube, but if anybody want to take a look at this stuff, you know what I'm saying, they're more than welcome to go and follow my Instagram. It's going to be on Cordova Dre. I'm going to put the pictures up and stuff right there. You know, the picture speaks more than anything. You know, the write-up could say whatever they want, but you see on the picture, you see him all bloody and stuff. You see me with the knife. He didn't do nothing to me, man.
No, absolutely. I mean, like I said, man, this is a... You know, he told his side of the story, and this is, you know, your side, which I have to concur, man. After doing my research and vetting everything, man, I have to say that you know, I have to agree, man, that you did your thing.
Absolutely.
You know, whether, like I said, I don't endorse or promote the writer movement, but at the same time, man, being that this is a prison-based genre, man, it is what it is, you know? Shit happens.
Yes. Yeah,
anyways, man, I appreciate your time, brother. I appreciate you coming on here and speaking to the viewers and being real righteous and gracious with it. At the same time, man, you know, all I can say, man, for me and mine, man, is that we feel for you. We hope that in your future, man, there's nothing but prosperity and that, and man, that you, you know, you get what you got coming in life as far as in there, bro. You know, and just keep your head on swivel. You know, the wiggleization is real no matter where you're at. It's always menudo time.
Likewise, my brother.
Absolutely.
Likewise, appreciate
man.
All that.
Oh, no doubt about it, man. So gracias. I'll be putting this out in the airwaves. And like again, man, like I say, I appreciate your time. Do you have anything to say, man, to anyone out there before we go?
No, man. I just want to give a big shout out to my big brothers, Snoop and Matt Bull Hooper, took part in this, you know what I'm saying? And to all the compas out there putting in work, man.
All right, brother. We appreciate you. With that being said, I hope that you guys got everything that you want coming to you. I hope that you move fast with a purpose. That's called hustling. At the end of the day, man, it's all about uniting the raza. I bring you real stories from real people doing it in a real way. And in that fashion, bang, bang, the gun, menudo.